Good morning, students. So today I will teach you the last topic of this chapter, that is birth control and STDs. STDs means sexually transmitted diseases. So as we know, the population is growing day by day. So it's very important to limitize the population now. So for that, we should take the preventive measures or the birth control methods, or we can adopt the birth control methods. As a female life is so much affected by the pregnancy, her body as well as her demands. So it's very important that's it in her wish. So if she wants to avoid this pregnancy, it can be. So for avoiding the pregnancy, the certain birth control methods can be used. So these are, so birth control methods we will discuss one by one. First is barrier method. That is with the examples are with the help of condom. That is a rubber sheet worn over the penis to stop the sperm from entering the vagina. Next is diaphragm. Diaphragm is also a rubber trap that is placed in the vagina over the cervix. Third is IUCD, that is intrauterine contraceptive device. It can say as copper T, placed in the uterus by doctors. It's all used to prevent pregnancies. So it can use side effects due to the irritation in the uterus. So this is all about the barrier method. Next is hormonal method. Hormonal method is given by prescribing the oral contraceptive pills. So these contain hormones which prevent the release of ovum. So if ovum will not release, definitely the fertilization will not take place. So the fertilization cannot occur. These disturb the hormonal balance of the body, and definitely it will cause the side effects, because this is not a natural method. You are inhibiting this release of ovum. So definitely it will cause adverse effect to the body. Next is chemical method. Chemical method is spermicides applied in the vagina that used to kill the sperms. It can be used with condoms or diaphragm. Next method is the safe period. Safe period means fertility period in women is from 14 to 16 days of menstrual cycle. So only 14 to 16 days will be the fertilized period. Adding 2 or 3 days on both sides and avoiding mating during this period automatically prevents conception. So these are about the four methods: barrier methods, hormonal methods, chemical methods, and safe period. Next, I will explain you about the surgical method. Okay, so the next method is surgical method. In surgical methods, two methods will be applied. In males, it's vasectomy, and in females, it's tubectomy. What is vasectomy? The small portion of sperm duct, or it is also called as vasa deferentia, is cut and tied properly. Therefore, the sperm transfer will be prevented. As I explained you that the sperm duct, or you can say that vasa deferentia, it carries sperms from testis to urethra. So that is, if the sperm duct, the small portion of sperm duct is cut, then the sperm can't reach to the urethra. So therefore, the sperm transfer will be prevented. Next is tubectomy. Tubectomy is in females, can be done in the females. As you know, the fallopian tube is there and oviduct is there. In fallopian tube or oviduct, the fertilization takes place. Here what will happen, the small portion of oviduct is cut and tied properly. If it is cut, then definitely the fertilization will not take place, hence the sperm transfers can be prevented. So these all are the preventive methods, or you can say the birth control methods. Okay, so the diagram of this vasectomy and tubectomy I am sending you in this image. And next topic we will be studying about STDs, that is sexually transmitted diseases. So next, sexually transmitted diseases. It transmits from one person to another person through sexual contact. We will study about the types of STDs. So the STDs may be the bacterial infection occurs by the bacteria, or the viral infection, okay, which caused by the viruses. So first I will let you know about the bacterial infection. Bacterial infection, first example example is gonorrhea. The causative organism is Neisseria gonorrhoeae, and it also transfers due to this unprotected sexual intercourse with an infected person, and also transfers from the mother from a mother to her fetus. Infects ureter in men and cervix in women. Treatment is by antibiotics. Obviously, it's a bacterial disease, then antibiotic will be effective while treatment is disease. And the symptoms of this gonorrhea is the discharge of pus from penis and vagina, burning sensation on urinating. So these all are symptoms of this bacterial infection. The name is gonorrhea, and the causative organism is Neisseria gonorrhoeae. Next is the bacterial infection is syphilis. Syphilis, the causative organism is Treponema pallidum, and it transmitted through the direct contact with the syphilis source. If you touch that syphilis source, that the person may get easily infected due to this, and this may occur mainly on the external genitals, vagina, anus, rectum, lips, and sometimes it occurs in lips as well as in mouth. Transmitted definitely, it's also STDs or sexually transmitted diseases. So it is also transmitted through the sexual contact. And the symptoms of the syphilis is appearance of sores in the body parts, and next fevers, ulcer, bone pain, liver disease, and anemia. So these all are symptoms of syphilis. And treatment, again, this is a bacterial disease, so the treatment will be the antibiotics against it. Also, antibiotic antibiotics can be taken to prevent or to maybe to prevent, can't say it, antibiotics can be taken to cure this disease. So next we will study about the viral infection. So the next is viral infection. Viral infection, the first example is AIDS. The full form of AIDS is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, and the causative agent of AIDS is HIV. HIV, the full form of HIV is human immunodeficiency virus. So as we know that it often called as AIDS is a syndrome, it's not a disease. Why? Because basically it weakens the immune system of a body, and if the immune system get weak, then definitely a person will not able to fight with the antigen. So it's not any disease, it's a syndrome. It basically finish the immunity of an person. So you can see it is incurable and fatal and suppresses the immune system of the body. As it is still also it's incurable because we didn't find any vaccine for this AIDS. Next, it transmits during sexual intercourse. It transmits by mother to fetus or from mothers to fetus. Next, by sharing needles or by blood transfusion, it can be transmitted from one person to another person. STDs disease that is caused by the virus is genital warts, and the causative organism is HPV, human papilloma virus. So causes warts over the external in this disease. What will happen? The warts over the external genitalia and perineal part area, the warts will be causing there. And podophyllum preparations are effective in treatment. Podophyllum is basically a plant. The roots and stem of this plant are underground stem it's having. The roots and underground stem of these plants will be used for the medicine purposes. So these about the these all are about the STDs. So how many STDs we read? In STDs we learnt about the bacterial infection and viral infection. In bacterial infection we see the disease name, that is the gonorrhea, and next we see the diseases like gonorrhea, and in the viral infection AIDS and genital warts. And in bacterial infection also, the syphilis. Gonorrhea, syphilis in bacterial infection and in viral infection, AIDS and genital warts. So, today we will finish this topic, that birth control methods and STDs. So, today we get finished this chapter also. So, go through the questions and complete the note part also. Thank you.